Hello, I'm Simon Whistler, you're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel, and in the video today we're looking at why clocks run clockwise. Pretty much everyone knows that if you're asked to pass something clockwise around a table, you hand it to the person on your left because that is the same direction that the hands of a clock move around the clock face. But what you may not know is that this standard direction is a function not only of timekeeping, but the Earth's rotation and the happy accident that much of human civilization evolved in the Northern Hemisphere. If you look directly at the North Pole from space, it will appear to spin counterclockwise. Given that spin, when a stick is placed in the ground parallel to the Earth's axis, say in Egypt, the shadow cast by the stick as the sun moves across the sky will move in a clockwise direction. Notably, a similarly placed stick in Australia would cast a shadow that moved counterclockwise. As far back as when the ancient Egyptians and Babylonians were fashioning their first shadow clocks around 3500 BC, the measurement of time moved in a clockwise direction. Even as more precise timekeeping methods came about, sundials, which began in earnest around 1500 BC, remained popular throughout the Middle Ages and beyond, given their simplicity of construction and relative reliability. In fact, early mechanical clocks were often regularly calibrated to nearby sundials. One of the earliest mechanical clocks, the Wells Cathedral Clock in Somerset, was wound by hands from its installation in the late 14th century to 2010 when an electric motor was installed, saving someone having to climb the steps and wind it, 800 revolutions per winding, 3 times per week. So when mechanical clocks were introduced in Europe in the 14th century, their inventors were quite familiar with sundials and the clockwise direction that their shadows moved and marked time. Accordingly, by the end of that century, when even cathedral clocks were sporting clock faces, they were made in imitation of their sundial forebears, which included hands that moved in a clockwise direction. Notably, the word clockwise, with its present meaning, did not appear in English until 1870, with counterclockwise also dating to that decade. The use of wise to mean a way of proceeding dates back to Old English. Clock isn't nearly so old and dates to the modern invention of mechanical clocks in the 14th century. It is thought to come from either clock, Middle Dutch, cloak, Old North French, or cloaca, Medieval Latin, all of which meant bell. Some of the earliest mechanical clocks were simply designed to strike a bell at intervals, perhaps to announce prayer times or the like, or simply ring on the hour, with these early clocks not necessarily having any faces. And if you're curious, before they were called clocks, these early mechanical clocks were called horologia, from the Greek hour and to tell. And now for a bonus fact. Have you ever wondered what AM and PM stand for? Well, wonder no more. AM stands for anti-meridian, which is Latin for before midday. PM stands for post-meridian, which is Latin for after midday. So I really hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, please do give us a thumbs up in the comments below. And if you've got an idea for a video that you might want us to address, leave it in the comments and we'll see what we can do. And if you see an idea that you like, give it a thumbs up, and the ones that rise to the top we will look at making into videos. Also, if you like this video, check out some of our other videos that are over there on the right, and thanks for watching.